We are about to gear up and jump in the water.
31-year-old Aussie Rhiannan Iffland dives off cliffs for a living. And she's the best on the planet. She won her first world championship in 2016 as a wild card.
Sheer brilliance, one of the rookies.
And she's ruled the sport ever since.
Another superb dive by the champion.
Not a drop of water left behind.
This woman here is the greatest of all time.
When Rhiannon's not jumping off cliff, after cliff, after cliff, after cliff.
Rhiannan Iffland, the unstoppable force of cliff diving.
She's diving off bridges, buildings, helicopters, even hot air balloons. And this month, Rhiannan dived from a purpose-built 27-metre platform in the middle of Sydney Harbour, clinching her sixth straight World Series title and fulfilling her dream of victory on home soil.
I think anything else that happens in my career now is just a bonus.
Would you please welcome Rhiannan? I'm so sorry that all we've got you tonight is a chair. It seems...
Yeah, I thought there'd at least be a platform here.
Congrats on this title and doing it in front of a home crowd. That must have been special.
Thank you. Yeah, it was kind of a moment I'd been waiting a few years for to bring the series to Sydney and put on a show in front of a home crowd. And, yeah, it was definitely a special one, the most special one yet.
It makes me feel sweaty even just watching the vision of you doing it. I get very clammy. Is it a dangerous sport?
Yeah, don't worry, I get nervous watching too. it is. I mean, we're jumping from, I mean, it's equivalent to a five-storey building. And we hit the water at speeds of up to 85 kilometres an hour. So,
wow.
You know, you can imagine there's a bit of danger there. And
because if you risky. Hit the wrong way, you'd break something.
Yeah, absolutely.
Have you thankfully, ever broken anything?
No, thankfully I've been lucky. I've put in the training behind the scenes. And
so wedges have been the worst.
Exactly.
How long does it take to become a cliff diver? You don't just wake up and become one.
No, it's not like, you know, we just watch a YouTube video and go up there and try. I began diving at around the age of 9 and I went through a almost 20-year career before I stepped into cliff diving and high diving. It's a sport that, you know, it's a bit more dangerous. So you really need to work on the fundamentals and the basic skills before you get up there.
Part of that 20-year career, or maybe this predated it, you were a diving entertainer on cruise ships. Did that involve cocktails?
I don't know if I can say that right now. maybe one or two, but, yeah, between my 10-metre and 3-metre, I guess, conventional-style diving career and my high-diving career, I was a performer on cruise ships and, diving my way around the Caribbean. So it was... It was a good transition from diving to high diving.
This is probably a stupid question, but into a pool, like not off the boat.
Into a pool, yeah.
You do dive in the most incredible locations. Is it ever distracting? Like, how do you focus and what do you say to yourself before you make that leap?
Yeah, look, it often is distracting, but it's a good distraction. I often find myself standing up on the platform and kind of using that, using the surroundings and using it to my advantage just to take in the atmosphere and to really enjoy what I'm doing. But,
And how do you know if it's deep enough?
look, it's always checked before. It's not a gamble.
Okay.
Because you were saying you've done, like, regular, like, Olympic pool diving or whatever as well.
Correct.
Now that you've done high cliff diving as well, do you look at that and go, like, oh, there are a bunch of cowards over there? You know, you can call them out now if you want. A bunch of scaredy cats in the pool?
Look, it's a little bit different, but it's a lot bigger risk jumping from 20 to 10 metre, you know? There's a lot of difference.
So they are cowards, please.
Maybe.
Do you still get, like, butterflies in your stomach when you... When you were up there on the cliffs?
Yeah, I think it's only normal. I don't think there's a time that I've walked up there and felt completely comfortable, to be honest. But, you know, it makes me human.
Yeah.
That thing that you people do, where you go backwards and you stand backwards and you're often standing there for 10 or 12 seconds, how do you not get the jitters? How do you not wobble a little bit before you do that?
Yeah, look, I think it's like all of the thinking and all of the nerves, I've kind of processed it before I stand backwards on the end of the platform. So I think, you know, it's not easy, but you do learn the more you do it, the easier it does become. And there's a few things that you focus on when you stand there. You don't focus on 100 different things. It's kind of just three key points.
And
just
what are
so
they?
Your mind's clear. It really depends on the dive. Like if you're spinning backwards, it might just be, you know, keep your head still, swing your arms fast, and then it's primarily focusing on the amount of twists and somersaults that you're about to do.
I love hearing that you get scared. It does make you feel more human. Is there anything else like a bit more menial that you're also scared of in your life?
Oh, spiders. An Australian of me, I know, yeah.
Spiders?
Yeah, spiders petrify me.
That old chestnut, it does make you human. Rhiannan, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.